Here is a plaque signifying your induction into the Ottawa Valley Country Music Hall of Fame. Also, we have a congratulatory letter from the Prime Minister. On behalf of the Ottawa Valley Country Music Hall of Fame,
thank you so much, Pam. Thank you all. Thank everybody on the board. I was really, truly astonished when I got the call for this. My guest was thoroughly flattered. because I do consider myself to be a sideman, one of the faceless little people in public business, like these faceless little people over here. In Murmansk, and we only have numbers, that's Zek number 26 over there. These are my people, these are musicians, these are the people who, like me, were bitten by the bug of music when they were too young to realize you'd spend the rest of your life never being quite as good as you wanted to be. I don't think they've all been introduced, but I know these guys, left to right across the bottom. That's Roger Colomb, Brian Hebert, Moody, Brian Austin, Justin King Jr., Will Parsono, right to left across the back, my current bandmate, Rick Rogers, Peter Bedoin, otherwise known as Boatman, and my old friend and fellow inductee, Eddie Bim. These are the guys that make it happen, are the people who are essentially the backdrop for the song, and they do it so artistically and so wonderfully. When you consider the Mona Lisa, it's probably the most recognizable painting on the planet. Everybody can instantly conjure an image of Mona Lisa, but hardly anybody can tell you what's in the background, other than it's not black. It's not a circus scene, and it's not underwater, or anything else. And if you're like most people, you're going to start Googling it right now. I expect some screams everywhere. What the heck does the Mona Lisa look like in the back? It's an interesting question because it's in perfect harmony with what the painting is. And that's what these guys do. That's what sidemen do, is we bring a song to be more of itself. I'm very moved at all the people who have been coming here today. My wife, my son, my mom, all the brothers who liked me enough to come. Scratch Mark from Christmas List. Friends who have traveled from Toronto, family who have traveled from Chicago. And the amazing thing is they've all come to see Ronnie McCann. I know that many of you were thinking, well, some of you, well, one person was thinking I might bring Herbie today, but no. Herbie is my puppy. And he is in, Heather, my wife, found a place for him to stay overnight. It sounds like fun. It's Crazy Igor's Puppy Gulag. For that true Siberian adventure, so it'll be interesting to see how that all works out. Do doing this, being a musician, means an awful lot of self-doubt and means an awful lot of practice, rehearsal, going over and over things, being frustrated, but getting the reward of being a musician, and that is beyond any value I can begin to describe. None of this is possible without the support of everybody I've ever worked with, everybody who has ever honored me by having me work with them on their record or in their band. I am more grateful than I can express for all of that, for all of those opportunities. But the one person who has made this the most possible for me is my wife Heather over here. Love and support, and told me to go to play with the other kids for over 40 years now. Honey, I love you. I couldn't be who I am without you. Thank you all. Thank you all, and now back to the festivities. More music, I think. What do you think, Pat? More music!